Hi, this is Pizad Rashid. In today's video, I want to quickly talk about different type of online editors you can use to learn C# coding. This video is about online editors used in the browser. I am not talking about IDE like Visual Studio or Jetbrains Rider. I don't want to confuse you with the IDE. Instead, I want you to start simple and focus on learning the language. Actually, there are many online editors you can use for C# coding, but I have selected three for this video. I have used two editors very extensively for preparing this video series, and it worked definitely very well for me. By the way, all the editors are lightweight and free to use in the browser. If you want to try more editors and choose the one that works best for you, then use the links at the end of this video for more options. I don't know about you guys, but I want few basic things in the editor. First, it should have a simple and clean interface. I don't want to see lots of ads popping up all over the page. Moreover, must have a simple to use interface. Another thing I want to see is code completion. I need auto completion with better IntelliSense support, which can provide smart completion based on the variable types, function definitions, etc. Lastly, syntax highlighting to improve the code readability. So let's start with the video. This is the first editor. Please remove this sample code and these imports. Forget all this code here. Don't worry. I will explain all this code in detail when I talk about namespaces, classes, methods, etc. Whatever code examples I use in this series will be coded here, between these two curly brackets. Now the first thing you will notice is the clean interface. There are no ads whatsoever. This is very simplified editor and my number one choice. I have recorded all the C# basic series using this editor. Currently it only supports C#. But there are plans to support F# and VB in the near future. Actually, Microsoft developed this editor and they are using it in the MSDN documentation as well to test out the examples. It has a very responsive IntelliSense. As I type, you can see all the methods listed here. You will see this statement repeatedly. Actually, this class is a way of referencing the classes that are in the system namespace. And this namespace contains many useful classes, one of which is console class. This is used to communicate with the console. Then this method of console class prints the value within parentheses on the console, which is this area. Now all you have to do is just click this run button to see the output. Another excellent option for an online editor is this one. This is another lightweight code editor which you can use. But it's like more advanced coding environment than the previous one. This is according to the .NET Fiddle. Actually, it allows you to write, test and share .NET code in your browser. Then you can save your fiddles as private or public, which will be available through these shared links for others to see. If you want to save your code, then you need to create an account on their website from here. It supports these languages. And you can create these project types with this editor. This is my second editor of choice. I have saved all the code examples here on .NET Fiddle, which I have used in my training videos. This way I could share all the links on my blog www.codebuns.com for you to quickly taste the code and instantly see the results without writing a single word. You can make the changes in the code according to your needs and taste it. Type in the code here between these curly brackets. and click this button to see the output. This is the output. This is the third editor I want to show you. It supports these languages. There are other options you can use. I haven't tried, so cannot say much about that. Use this area to type your code. And this one is for output. So the good thing about this editor is its auto run feature. Let me show you. As soon as you type in the code, you can see the output here. See the instant feedback. You don't have to push any button again and again to see the result of your code. Let's complete the statement and you will see the editor response according to that. If there are no errors, this area will be blue. The same feature is available in .NET Fiddle but very limited. I like it here. It's fast and more responsive. Try yourself and see the difference. Maybe I am wrong.